Hello friends, how are you? I'm Mari Theriger and today I'm going to make a book review. I usually record the videos on the runes in this exact spot with this background, and some of you noticed a couple of books including Hellrunnar. This isn't going as planned. Right, here's the little devil. Some of you wanted me to make a review of this book and, well, why not? From now on, I think I will only make reviews of books that are really worth reading. There's no point in wasting time with certain books, unless, of course, obviously, it's to warn you about works that can greatly misguide you. Now, I have plenty of books about the runes. Some are good, others are absolutely terrible, and only a few are really good. And Hellrunnar is definitely on my personal list of top 5 books on the runes. Rune magic. This is not the average book that tells you the name of the runes, the symbol, a little text with the meaning. No. This book deals with the magic of the runes. And there it is, Hellrunnar, a manual of rune magic written by Jan Friis. Although I must underline that this is not the sort of book that you would use for an academic work and put it on the references you have consulted. There is certainly a good historical introduction on how the runes came to be and a well-structured synthesis, but the great majority of the content you can find in this book deals with the more, let's say, exoteric aspect of the runes. After all, it is rune magic. The book starts with a series of discussions and interpretations of the historical background of the runes, the process of evolution of runic symbols, and the impact of different cultures upon those very symbols, creating a perception that the runes weren't just letters, but start off as expressions of a variety of principles of nature, humanity, and the cosmos. I was actually surprised to see in this book the runes of northern Portugal, which in this book don't get a lot of attention, but it's perfectly understandable why in some cases the author doesn't develop much, because each year there are always new findings and history has to constantly be revised, and the author is actually well aware of that. He mentions that same aspect. The various historical theories have to be revised, and he himself clarifies and revises some of his own claims, which is good. It is a good sign. So far, it's the only book about runes that I have read, and I have read quite a lot, that mentions other realities outside Scandinavia. And that alone already demonstrates that the author of the book is not Scandinavian-centered and is actually interested in knowing, understanding, and sharing the knowledge of the runes, rune magic, making a deeper analysis. So it isn't one of those unoriginal books that everybody writes and it's always about the other Futhark or solely on the perspective of the Viking runes. The author explores starts to explore the origins of the runic symbols and various rune rows, passing through what we know of ancient runic inscriptions, jumping into the Nazi misuse of runes and early Germanic culture and religion. Nowadays, from book to book, on more exoteric subjects or that lean over, so to speak, on the occult, we are almost always rereading something that has been said before, and there is little new about it. However, Jan Friis manages to create genuinely innovative methods and systems in his books, and this is not the only book I have read of him, so I was already expecting this to be truly an uncommon book, really worth the time. So you really need to know that about him. However, as you know, I myself separate my academic work from the occult, so there are certain claims in this book that obviously no one from the academic field would take seriously. So you do have to make that distinction as well. When reading this book, try to create a balance with the academic and with the occult. As I've said, this is not a book to be used as a reference for academic works. And in all honesty, Jan Fries seems to be quite aware of that. His works are not meant to be academic, but precisely dealing with magic or freestyle shamanism, as he calls it. And it was in fact him who came up with that expression. His works always follow a concrete line that succinctly defines his own approach to magic in general, be that primordial, physical, practical, dynamic, intense, free of dogmas. So if you are a traditionalist, folkish even, you probably won't like this book because it will touch on a variety of realities about the runes that are foreigner to the usual information about the runes, which is always or seems to be always in the perspective of Scandinavia or the Germanic world in general, because for various political reasons it's convenient to forget all the other realities. This is not a book to continue to feed political notions upon religion. This is a book that is meant to learn and to teach about the runes and rune magic. Now, just like other works from Jan Fries, this is not a book that forces you to believe in his claims. On the contrary, actually, the author encourages you to read his work with the critical thinking in the attempt that you open your mind to a variety of possibilities outside the usual cliches. This is a book meant to explore the psychological depth of the runes. It's certainly a useful book, not to learn about the history of the runes, but to learn about the magic of the runes, to help you out experience the runes by yourself, to give you just a little push on the process of self-transformation by the use of runic wisdom and runic magic. Now, take special care with the lists of various rune poems with translations the author gives. He gives his own etymological insights, but at times this can be quite sparse and, well, honestly, poorly connected. But I do believe it's on purpose, judging by other works of his, because Jan Fries seems to always want to focus on the perspective that encourages the reader of his works to seek more personal interpretations. In my opinion, this isn't by any means a primary source or guide for rune magic, and I underline rune magic. Definitely not a source to seek an accurate historical background of the runes, but also not a primary source for rune magic, but without a doubt an outstanding, let's say, supplement for the rune lore and an exceptional addition to the works of magic in general. Also, Jan Fries does something that I would very much like to do if I ever wrote a book, or rather, if I ever have the time to finish the dozen books I have started writing. Jan Fries makes his own illustrations, which gives you a glimpse into his own imagination, which is pretty cool. Now, do I recommend this book? I do, absolutely. It's worth the reading. All right, my dear friends, I hope you have enjoyed this video, and I hope my book review on Hel Runar was useful. I wish you a continuation of a good and prosperous harvest, October, and say goodbye to this little pumpkin because I'm going to make a soup out of it. Thank you so much for watching, see you on the next video, and as always, don't forget.